Helping God to Help You. Roland studied a very good course in school and was probably one of the best in his chosen field. However, he had very great difficulty keeping a job. He would find a very good, well-paying job, but before he knew it, he would either resign in anger or get terminated. His ego seemed to play a great role in making this happen. He didn't seem to be able to easily submit to constituted authority, and he argued a lot with his superiors. With a wife and children to fend for, it was a big concern that Roland wouldn't do whatever was needed in order to retain a job. One day, at a time when Roland was once again unemployed, Nick, a concerned brother in Christ, reached out to him, suggesting that the two of them should have a conversation. Roland's response was something like this: "We are holding on to the word of assurance and encouragement the Lord gave us through you years ago." Roland probably supposed that Nick was going to give him another one of those sermons about how he needed to ask God for grace to calm down, follow office rules, treat his co-workers with respect, and do everything to retain the next job the Lord would give him. God made a lot of promises to us in the Bible. He also talks to us, making specific promises to us every now and again. For instance, the Lord may tell his sister who has been praying for the gift of husband that her God-chosen man will locate her in the next 6 months. As she rejoices and holds on to God's hands in prayer, waiting for the fulfillment of his promise, she also needs to be careful and watchful, since she doesn't know who exactly the Lord is bringing to her and when he will bring him. She cannot afford to conduct herself just anyhow or look down on any man. She may be trusting God for a wealthy man, but what if the man God has for her is the unemployed brother who has just started coming to her church? If she despises him without knowing he's her God-chosen marriage partner, she may be prolonging her waiting days. God may tell a brother who just got a new job that nothing and nobody will be able to take the job from him. The brother will be hurting himself terribly if, on the strength of God's promise, he decides to get to work late and leave early, sleep or spend too much time on social media instead of doing his work, disobey office rules, quarrel with all his co-workers, disrespect his bosses, and so on. Since God doesn't acquit the guilty or condemn the innocent, Proverbs chapter 17 verse 15, we can be sure that he will not do such a thing even for someone to whom he has made a promise. Therefore, he will not stand to support his son who deliberately chooses to do wrong just because he has received a promise from the father. God may assure a couple that just got a new baby that he will protect the baby and make certain that he survives and becomes great in life. He reminds them of Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 14. "I know that whatever God does, it endures forever. Nothing can be added to it, nor can anything be taken from it. For God does this so that men with fear and worship him with all filled reverence, knowing that he is God." That's the Amplified Bible. And also Isaiah chapter 4 verses 5 and 6. "Then the Lord will create over the whole site of Mount Zion and over its assembly a cloud by day and smoke and the light of a blazing fire by night. Over all the glory there will be a canopy, which will be a booth by day for shade from the heat and a hiding place and shelter from a stormy downpour." That's the Common English Bible. The Lord promises to ensure that the enemy does not exact upon the child and that the son of wickedness does not afflict him, Psalm 89 verse 22. But what happens if the parents fail to play their own role in keeping their baby alive and in good health? What if they don't feed him when he's hungry? What if they give him food that is not right for someone of his age? What if he's left in dirty diapers all day long every day? What if his parents don't take him to get his shots as and when due? What if the parents are generally careless with him or don't see any reason why they should do for him what parents are expected to do for their young babies just because God has promised to take care of the child? A Christian sister once said that she wouldn't need to bother about taking care of her babies. She could always ask the angels to change their diapers, prepare their food, feed them, rock them to sleep, and so on. The sad part was that she meant it. What were angels there for? Part of their duty, according to her, was to take care of the babies of God's children. When God makes you a promise, don't take steps that could make it difficult for him to fulfill it. Walk in wisdom. May the Lord help us all in Jesus' name. Amen.